What are some common mistakes that parents make but don't realize it? Part 2. Coddling kids. Especially those with mental and even minor mental issues. My brother has mild Asperger's and all he gets is pampering. He cracked eggs and hid all of it under his bed and got no more than a slap on the wrist. He constantly gets away with punching people who don't agree with him, even in school. He's 8 and this is unacceptable. A friend of mine has a younger brother who is autistic and he's getting bigger and bigger and is very violent, but her parents never do anything about it. Her brother destroyed hundreds of pounds worth of their stuff, bullies her other brother and physically hurts her, but gets nothing for it. I'm incredibly worried for my friend as her brother is growing up and getting really strong. Misuse of car seats. It's unfortunate the number of parents or caregivers who don't know how to properly strap a child in to keep them safe. The lack of enforcement bugs me. Every day I see very young kids in the front seat with no belt at all, hanging out the window like a dog. And our town cops do nothing. They don't want to rustle any feathers with the locals. They just want the ticket speeders from out of town. Not teaching their children about sex. Do you know how much unprotected sex I had in high school because no one taught me how easy it was to get pregnant or worse, an STD? I was way too young to be having sex in the first place, and I can't help but think that if I had the proper information growing up, I might have saved myself from someone. I could have had a future with. Good thing I don't have any babies or incurable STDs, because I could have ruined my life. Please talk to your kids about sex so that they can at least be open with you about it. And people that are sexually active, please use protection if there is any chance of unwanted pregnancy or STDs. Using food as a reward. Working with toddlers, I'm okay with food rewards to a point. Potty training is hard and kids get it at different points. An M&M for using the toilet is fine, but it needs to taper off. I don't use rewards for things they should be doing. When a kid asks you the serious questions like, how are babies made? Caitlyn Jenner stuff, drugs, whatever. Most parents either lie outright or distract the kid to avoid answering. Then they go on talk radio and blame others saying, how am I supposed to talk to my 8-year-old about this? How about you just answer their questions? Straight up, no flowery answers. Give them the truth at whatever age they ask for it. I decided to do this with my kids. No regrets. Give them the truth in any age-appropriate way, but just answer the question they ask. Not the whole thing necessarily, just what they asked. Pushing children too hard to perform perfectly in school. I think parents should celebrate the kids' little victories, like passing a test that was really difficult for them, even if it wasn't a perfect A+. I knew too many of my peers throwing up who would break down in tears if they got a B or something, or even an A-, because their parents would be disappointed in them. It's good to encourage kids to do well in school, but not that extreme. I was one of those kids. One of my memories from middle school was getting a 97 on a test and being asked where the other 3 points went. After a while, you start feeling really inadequate. Heavily enforcing their own beliefs on their child and not allowing them to think for themselves or discover themselves. I never thought this was a problem when I was younger, but now that I'm an adult still living with them, I've learned that it kills them that I'm not a conservative Republican who sits there and watches Fox News without question. They made it non-negotiable for me to go to college. And then, as it turns out, they don't like the opinions I formulated about my country and about politics as a result of the government classes. I've taken teaching me to be an informed voter. This is actually something I'm grateful to my parents for. I don't have the same political views as they do. I'm more middle of the road, while they are solidly right wing. However, they're not mad about that because they were the ones who taught me to think for myself in the first place. They just accept that not everyone thinks alike. Have debates about it every now and again and let it go. Taking their child or children for granted. Similarly, expect respect just because they are their sons, even when they lack to show that some respect towards the children. Don't raise a kid that's going to have to recover from his childhood. Very well said. The expectation that the child fits into the mold that the parents make needs to go away. Hitting their kids out of anger, or maybe hitting them at all. American Academy of Pediatrics agrees with you. Plenty of people will say, but my parents hit me and I turned out fine. Lots of parents do horribly abusive things to their kids and the kids turn out as high-functioning adults. It does not mean the abuse was a good idea. It does not mean no damage was done. if you can hit your friend, spouse, pets, etc., when you ought not to hit a child either. Assault is assault, and there are more appropriate ways to discipline a child. Assuming that their child always tells the truth, more the opposite. When you make a mistake, admit it, apologize, and correct it, especially if it's a mistake that affected your child. It teaches your kids an important lesson about humility. If you get angry about them wanting an apology or something of the like, then they won't want to open up to you later on. Similarly, if you do something your kid doesn't like, even if you find their reaction cute or the act of doing it fun, stop it. It hurts them that you keep on doing this thing at their expense. For example, whenever I brought up a problem to my father, he'd like to say that he'll call the mayor and have him fix it. I never found this to be funny. In fact, I saw it as an insult to my intelligence. But it was only years later that I learned how to articulate it as such. This is good advice. I love my parents, but my mom never apologizes when she's made a mistake. For example, one time she got hair dye on one of my favorite sweaters. And when I told her about it later, she just said, "What? But how could that happen? I was just using the hair dye the time you got into the bathroom." Except clearly not, because there is a big spot of dye right there. No, sorry, no office to replace it, which I didn't want anyway. I just wanted an apology. But she acted like nothing happened. She also never lets her kids own their emotions. Like if my brother or I ever angry at her, she gets all, "Are you mad at me? Why? You shouldn't be mad. I was just blah, blah, blah." It feels really infantilizing. I don't know. I hope this doesn't get buried. Teach your children respect by respecting them. Reiterate throughout the early years that they are responsible for everything they think, say, and do. And by pointing out that by being responsible for these things, it will lead to their being responsible for the success in their life. Not enough parents respect their children and subsequently do not receive respect. Just bringing up another point. My older brother, best brother ever, seriously, brought up the point that I don't really deserve or can't earn respect. I didn't really know what he meant, but it stuck with me. I agree with your point though. You reap what you sow, kind of thing. Making comments that insist that their kid is straight. Or saying, "I'll love you no matter what you are," and then completely going back on that when their kid comes out, or just pretending like the kid is straight anyway. Thinking that they are raising children, instead, they should think about raising future adults. From the beginning of my child's years, when they started talking, my wife and I never spoke to them like they were children. Any conversations used proper grammar and sentence structure. As a result, my youngest daughter has the strangest vocabulary for her age. She's always saying, "as well," never, "also," for example. When you tell your kid they can't do something, don't just say no. And for crying out loud, don't ever say, "because I said no." Kids aren't stupid. Say no and explain why they can't. 90% of the tactum inciting incidences that I've had come up since becoming a parent have been avoided because of this method. I agree with this a lot. I was responding to another person's post on this thread. My mother would tell me to be more social, so I asked her if I can go to a friend's house the following day as an act of being more social. She said no. I asked why. "Because I said so." And of course, this pisses me off a lot because I'd love the actual answer. Tell me that you don't trust me on my own or something. Don't tell me because I said so. When your kids begin having crushes and start relationships, don't undermine their feelings of love by implying their emotions are misguided, immature, and or childish. I remember when I got into my first semi-serious relationship, my mother looked me in the eye and told me it wouldn't last. I stayed with that abusive person for way too long just to prove to her that she was wrong and that someone was capable of loving me. Being their friend instead of a parent. My best friend's mom is like this. She lets her spend the night with her boyfriend alone. She was okay with her having sex and smoking weed and drinking, all at the age of 12. She now has an 8-month-old son and is raising him on her own at the age of 18. Being told not to talk back. Even though the kid is providing valid arguments, it just prevents them from wanting to discuss things with you because you don't allow open discussions. Yes, talk to your kids like they're actual people. Don't just follow the script of the concerned parent and ignoring what they're actually saying. OFC, still be concerned and caring, but don't fall into the trap of just being concerned and caring and not engaging them on an intellectual level as well as just the emotional level. Positive reinforcement. Don't say, "you are stupid." Say, "you're smarter than that. I always heard you're smarter than that, and while I agree it's better than calling your kid stupid, I feel like a high expectation has come from me to be a smart person. Sometimes I just want to do stupid stuff that could get me hurt. It's part of growing up.